One of the key skills that you can possess and should possess as an incident commander or officer is the ability to use the incident command system, or ICS. Very critical. It will help you organize your incident early, maintain a good manageable span of control, and maintain the alignment we talked about. A lot of people think that ICS should only be used for large-scale incidents. Not true. It should be used for everyday house fires. That will help you maintain your alignment, your accountability, and your manageable span of control. Very, very critical to set up your groups and divisions early and maintain that tactical alignment like we talked about earlier. To effectively use ICS, we've developed the ICS formula. The building, the conditions, and the resources together determine how you're going to use ICS. It's an ICS formula. For example, if you have a large commercial building, you're probably not going to have an interior division or a fire tech group. You're probably going to have Division Alpha, Bravo, Charlie, and Delta based on the point of entry. A large two-story or three-story or multi-story commercial building is going to have divisions 1, 2, 3, and 4. If you have a known rescue in a home or a duplex or a townhome or a small apartment, fourplex, for example, you may choose to use a fire tech group and a rescue group. The point is this: don't utilize ICS or make it up on the fly. You can pre-plan your ICS just like you can pre-plan a building, based on those three principles and those three components: the building, the conditions, and the resources. That will help you determine how to use ICS. If you have that in your mind, then you'll know how to organize your incident rapidly and get ahead of the curve on organizing your resources.